I would be happy for you to take photos on two conditions, anyway. First of all, you have to promise to send copies of all of your pictures to the happy couple. And secondly, you have to promise not to upload anything to Facebook before the end of the day. Tomorrow is fair game, but not today, if you're not. So feel free to snap away those two conditions, the more the merrier. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, would you be upstanding, please, for the arrival of the bridal party? And respect for others and for the wider world in which we all live. And no matter what we each individually believe, I think you'll agree that these are values that we all share, and also values that make a strong foundation for a long and happy marriage too. Now, undoubtedly, one of the most important aspects of today for Martina and Phil is to be able to share this day with their family and friends, because as far as these two are concerned, folks, you are all their VIPs. Now, I know that some of you have travelled a long way to be here today from various parts of Scotland, and that's very much appreciated, but whether you're from near or far, your presence here to witness their marriage means the world to Martina and Bill, so thank you to all of you. Now, I know that you're all very fond of these two, and I should perhaps have begun by calling them by their nicknames, because of course, to many of you, these two aren't Martina and Bill or Billy, they are actually Mudz and Buff, of course. Now, Mudz and Buff are very, very keen that you all have a great time today, and they want you to mix and match and be merry in each other's company. Now, I have a funny feeling that you will not be letting me down on that one. Hang on, we're just going to move the bride forward slightly. we don't want her on fire before the end of the ceremony. Just move forward then. And then just move across the Yes, well, these two really do want you to have fun, and I'm sure you won't let them down, because it is promising to be a really good party today. And by the way, I should also announce, folks, that during the ceremony, laughing, clapping, cheering, whooping, whistling, hollering, and heckling are all positively encouraged. Feel free. And as you will have discovered when you sat down, you will have found something on your seat that makes a noise. So later on, when we pronounce them husband and wife, I want you to make the maximum possible noise that you you can. Now, Bill and Martina, I want you all to feel very involved today, and they're very pleased also to have some special friends and family members as their attendants too. So Bill has two best men, and they are his good mate Stevie and his son Reese. And on the girls' team, Martina's lovely bridesmaids are her friend Marion's maid of honour, her daughter Keely, and their niece Leah. Now, Marion and Stevie are going to be witnesses for the signing of the marriage schedule later on too. And somebody else with a really important role today too is Martina's son, Caden. Now, it is, of course, traditional for the bride to be given away, and I'm sure that Caden was very proud and very happy to walk his mum down the aisle on the wedding day. Now, in reality, of course, Martina and Bill are both strong and independent people with relationship equals, so there's no actual giving away as such today, and the groom certainly isn't here to claim any form of ownership over his bride, are you, Bill? Thank you, we've got the right answer. Now, seriously, these two are, of course, already in a committed relationship, and in that sense, they are already given to each other. At the same time, though, I do know that they would like to acknowledge the role that their families have played in their lives, to thank them for all the love and the support that they've given them both as individuals and as a couple. So, now to the happy couple themselves. Now, these two tell me that they had known each other for years just to say hi, but that they got chatting when they ended up at the same blood donor session at Ulver Town Hall. Now, they had a good blender that day, and Bill then Facebooked Martina to suggest going on a date. Now, I do wish I could say that true love ran a smooth course, but sadly I can't. Because the less said about that first date, the better. So both tell me that it was a complete disaster. Now, actually, it wasn't until a couple of years later that they reconnected, again, courtesy of good old Facebook, and Bill suggested a second date to make up for that first disastrous one. Now, this time he turned up with a huge bunch of flowers and chocolates, and she was well impressed. He's a real gentleman. And Bill's first impressions of Martina, well, let's just say that they were very favourable. In fact, he told me that he thought he was functioning well above his weight, and that he could not believe it when she said yes to that second shift. And this time, Cupid's arrow had a lot more success. They had a lovely meal together at the City Walls in Stirling, followed by a night of dancing at the Corn Exchange. And yes, before you ask, alcohol was indeed consumed in considerable quantities that evening. They assured me, though, that the spark between them had absolutely nothing to do with beer goggles. They got on really, really well together, and Modena tells me that she simply laughed her socks off all night that night. They both knew, I think, that this was going to be something really special, and the rest is history, because they've been a couple ever since. Now, as you will know, they share the same outlook on life, the same goals and values, and the same dark sense of humour. They laugh together a lot, both with and indeed at each other. They also tell me that they often say and do the same thing at the same time and finish each other's sentences. And in many ways, in fact, they are like an old married couple already. Now, Bill and Modena love spending time together, and they tell me that their two families have come together seamlessly. They met each other's family early on, and I gather that Caden was calling Bill Dad from about week three. Now, having been on her own for years before she and Bill got together, I know that Modena found it difficult to go from being Miss Independent to allowing herself to be looked after by somebody else. But Bill has really been there for her every single step of the way, and she tells her that his love and support has been amazing. Now, although these two are very similar in some ways, there are of course some major differences between them. So where Bill here enjoys his bowls and is seriously into the football, Modena fails to appreciate or indeed care about the final points of the beautiful game. Mind you, by the same token, he is none too keen on her beloved EastEnders Corrie or Emmerdale either. Modena is also very outgoing compared to Bill, who is naturally quieter. She also cheerfully admits that she is extremely impatient too. And Bill assures me that that is a massive understatement. Modena is very, very organised and tidy as well, but she can get stressed and flustered at times. Bill, on the other hand, is steady and laid back, and he calms her down. In fact, they complement each other really well, and I think you will all agree that these two make a great team. Now, when we met up to prepare this ceremony, I asked these two to tell me three things that they love about each other, but to keep their thoughts a secret from one another. So now, on their wedding day, I'm going to reveal their answers. Tissues at the ready, folks. It's all our stuff here. And they are man size, just in case. Now, the first thing that Modena told me is that she loves you, Bill, for making her feel secure and loved, especially when you wrap your arms around her. She also loves you for the way that you seem to be able to hear her thoughts, so that the two of you often end up saying the same thing at the same time. And that shows how really close you are. Finally, she ended with these lovely words for you, Bill, and I'm going to quote her directly as she said these words. I love the way that you take time to show me how much you love me. You are my beginning and my happy ending. Not here yet. That's the tissue, I can't hear you. Regardless of what happens, nothing fazes you. You just keep a really positive attitude and get on with things. He also loves the way that you are so well organised and so prepared for everything. And he added that he loves your wee mists. Finally, he ended by saying that he loves the way that you care for and love him. You make him feel so good about himself, and he told me that you make him a better person. Actually, I said finally, but he cheated, and he slipped in something else, because he said, and again I'm going to quote it exactly, I do also love her eyes. Wait for it. I do also love her eyes, her smile, and her cute butt. Now, Bill and Marina became engaged on the 15th of February this year, and although they both knew that they had found the one, and it was always a matter of when rather than if they would get married, the actual proposal itself was a complete surprise for Bill. Now, they had had a lovely meal out for Valentine's Day, and the following day, Marina decided to pop the big question. So, Bill and Mel lying in bed Saturday morning, and Bill asked her what she was doing that day. To which she replied, "Let's get married, but it has to be before 12 p.m. And he laughed because actually he still thought he was full of the drink from the night before. But after a few minutes, he then said that they couldn't get married because she actually hadn't asked him yet properly. A few more minutes passed, and then Marina said, "Billy, will you marry me?" He still thought she was under the influence, by the way, but he replied, "Yes, of course I will marry you, honey." In fact, it wasn't until the following day, after a fabulous day out at Glen Sheen, that it actually dawned on him that she was being serious. And by that time, the announcement was on Facebook, of course, and I think it was only when people started congratulating him that Bill realised that it was all real. I mean, he was actually going to marry Regina, who he describes as the most amazing, gorgeous woman in the whole world. Now, he also sent these lovely words to her a few months ago, and they express perfectly how these two feel about each other and about getting married. And it's an honour to read these words on their wedding day. So this is what he wrote. "My love for you grows stronger every day. Every day we spend apart is a day lost together, but also a day more that I am truly in love with you. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you and to walk down the aisle with you for us to be husband and wife and be a family together. I can't put into words how you make me feel every day, but I know my life, since you have been a part of it, has been totally transformed into a truly happy life, one full of love, and I never want it to end. I love you so much, and I am so much in love with you." He's a big old romantic, isn't he? And he's so sweet. Oh, I'm going to bring in the tissue. There's a few people. So Bill and Marina, you clearly have all of the ingredients for a long and happy marriage, because your partnership is based on deep friendship, mutual respect, total trust, and unconditional love. Now, life can be great fun sometimes, and it can also be tough sometimes too, as you know, but supporting each other through those times has made you stronger as a couple. Now, there will no doubt be many more highs and lows as you continue your journey together, but you are making a commitment to spend the rest of your lives together, and by loving and caring for one another and for your children, through both the good times and the bad times, you will be building a strong and happy marriage and a strong and happy family. Now, we have now come to the most important part of our ceremony today, when the vows of commitment will be exchanged. Now, I know that Bill and Martina have thought very seriously about the commitment that they are making today, and that their vows will be heartfelt and sincere. Now, in centuries past, it was the tradition for couples in Scotland to be married through a ritual of hand fasting, and Bill and Bardina will be exchanging their vows in this traditional Celtic manner. I'm going to tie some tartan around their joint hands as a way of confirming their union and symbolising their marriage. And this ancient ritual is, by the way, almost certainly why we describe getting married as tying the knot. And we're going to be using McNeil and Bailey tartans to represent their respective roots and to symbolise the joining together of their two families through their marriage. So Stevie, would you step forward to the table? Ready to tie the knot. Now the first knot that I'm going to tie is to represent Martina's love for you, Bill. And the second knot is to represent Bill's love for you, Martina. This hand fast is symbolic of the strength of the love and the commitment you share as a couple. I would now like to join both hands, please. You now stand with one hand freely joined and one hand tied, just as you are free to love each other, but also willingly bound in that love. And the hands you are holding today are the hands of the person who will be by your side always, to love, honour, support, and care for you for the rest of your life. And if you'd now like to exchange the personal vows of marriage that you have chosen to make to one another today.
Ben, I love you. Today, before our family, our friends and the world, I'm proud to take you as my husband, loving what I know of you and trusting what I do not yet know. I look forward to loving you and falling in love with you a little bit every day. I promise to love and cherish you always, and to stand beside you as your partner while we build our future and achieve our dreams together. I promise to be your best friend, to respect your individuality, to trust you, and to be honest with you throughout the whole life you have.
Now for your legal declarations of marriage. So, Mardina, if you'd please repeat after me the following words. I, Mardina Ann McLaren,
I, Mardina Ann McLaren,
solemnly and sincerely declare,
solemnly and sincerely declare,
that I accept you, William Bailey,
that I accept you, William Bailey,
as my lawfully wedded husband.
My
And Bill, if you please repeat after me. I, William Bailey,
I, William Bailey,
solemnly and sincerely declare,
solemnly and sincerely declare,
that I accept you, Mardina Ann McLaren,
I accept you, Mardina Ann McLaren,
as my lawfully wedded wife.
And my lawfully wedded wife.
Thank you. Now, Bill and Mardina, you have bound yourselves together by these vows. And as we now remove the tartan, may the real bond of love between you remain unbroken for the rest of your lives. Now, Bill and Mardina are now going to exchange their wedding rings. So if I could ask you to step forward with the rings, please. Thank you. Now, Bill and Mardina, these rings. things will remind you every day of your love for each other. So wear them always, and whenever you look at these rings, think about each other and remember the happiness you felt on this, your wedding day. So Merdina, would you now please place the ring on Bill's finger and repeat after me. Bill, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and as a token of my commitment to you and to our family. As a token of my commitment, to you and to our family, to you and to your family, from this day forward, until the end of time. And Bill, would you now please place the ring on Merdina's finger and repeat after me. Merdina, I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love, and as a token of my commitment to you and to our family, from this day forward until the end of time. To reflect on their marriage in your own individual way. Please don't disappear anywhere, folks. We will be back to continue with the last part of the ceremony in just a few moments. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Too much to drink. Enjoy. Now, speaking of your good wishes, I've now got a little question to ask all of you. Now, Modena and Bill have made sincere and binding promises to one another today, and I would now like to ask if you would make a promise to them. Now, they have invited all of you here today to be a part of their wedding day, and I know that they want you all to continue to play an important role in their lives in the future too. So, I'm going to ask you a question, and I am, by the way, expecting a really big, loud yes by way of an answer. In fact, if you don't raise the roof, folks, we're not going to open the bar. So, let's...